and good morning. Good morning. This is Life Beats Radio, and I'm your host, Dawn Mack. And first off, I just want to say happy Memorial Day. Our thanks and our appreciation go out to all the men and women who have sacrificed their lives, given the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. And today is a day of remembrance. It's a day to remember not only those who lost their lives in, you know, on the front line in battle, but also the families of those who have lost their lives. Because, you know, as we all celebrate with our cookouts, and, you know, maybe some of you are at the beach vacationing today, others of you are maybe getting some things done outside, or you're going to enjoy some fun things outdoors. You know, those families will, this day will be a bittersweet day. It'll be a somber day. It will not be the kind of day that we will celebrate. But, you know, our society reveres, you know, celebrities and sports stars and you name it as heroes. But the real heroes are those who have given the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. Because without those men and women doing that, no one would be able to do anything in this country. And we are very, very grateful. There are not enough words of thanks or, you know, ways to express our gratitude for what they've done for us. And so as we go about our day today, let's just remember those who protect and serve our freedoms. And for those of you who are currently serving in the military or you're a veteran of the military, of our armed forces, we applaud you, we thank you, and we appreciate you. And although Veterans Day acknowledges those who are living, who serve, I think it's important to also say a thank you to those who are living today as well, because you made a decision, and it's not an easy decision. It's one of huge, huge sacrifice. And, you know, you not only give up your life to protect and serve our country, and there is no greater love, in my opinion, but, you know, you're away from family. Families, you know, have to go for long stretches when their loved ones are away on deployment, and it can be very, very rigorous and very tough. So we just want to say a huge thank you and applaud each and every one of you who serve and protect our borders and our country and our great nation. God bless America, and for all the things that are wrong in our country right now, you know, that is the one thing that is right. Our American military is strong, is brave, and courageous, and, you know, our sense of love and deep appreciation for what you do, as I say, can never be said enough or expressed enough. Happy Memorial Day to everyone out there, and whatever you do today, please, always remember, take a moment to remember those who are fallen in the line of duty, and just, you know, make this day about that. But, you know, on a lighter note, with all that said, I hope where you are today, the weather is going to cooperate with you and it's going to be absolutely gorgeous. So far today, I'm seeing it is shaping up in this early morning hours here in North Carolina. It is shaping up to be quite a beautiful morning. And I think that's a great precursor to today. And I can't help but think that God is smiling down on us as a nation and is giving us the sunshine, at least here in North Carolina. You know, is giving us the sunshine as a way of, you know, smiling on those who gave that ultimate sacrifice. And so, you know, as it says in the Bible, there's no greater love than to lay down a life for a friend. And so, you know, I just think about that on this day. But enjoy your day. I hope it's a great day for you. And I hope you get out and do something fun because, you know, it is a day of celebration as well, a celebration of our freedom. And that is so very important when you think about all the countries in the world who don't have the kind of freedoms we do that are so envious. I mean, we are so, you know, envied and hated by so many countries. Obviously, by the acts of terror that, you know, get taken out on us or attempted on our land by those from foreign lands. And, you know, we are to be envied. I mean, our other countries do wish they had what we had. We are the greatest nation on earth. I know we have our fair share of problems, but at the end of the day, we can be very grateful and very thankful for the freedom that we have, the freedom of expression and the freedom to, you know, for me to be able to get on air this morning and chat with all of you, and the freedoms to go about our business and our lives and work and play as we choose. And the men and women who we recognize and honor today are the reason why we have that. So I hope you have a great day, all. And so I want to welcome everyone in this morning. We are airing this morning our recent interview that we did with comedian Anita Renfroe. And as many of you know, Anita is so well known in the world of Christian comedy, but she has traveled all over taking her show on stage to many, many places. I'm sure many of you have seen her. She has appeared on Good Morning America many times. She's written numerous books. You know, she's also famous. What made her famous was that infamous mommy song, the mom song, that was posted on YouTube some years back and started, you know, it went viral in no time. And, Anita's one of these people that, through comedy, says what every mom thinks or says what people think, but she has the courage to voice it. She's a delightful lady. I had such a great time speaking with her and so enjoyed, you know, the opportunity to chat with her. And unfortunately, her schedule did not permit her to be here live because she is currently on tour and just has a lot going on. But we were so, so very thankful and blessed to be able to have a little bit of time with her to chat with her about her career and all the many things that she has accomplished and has coming up moving forward. So without further ado, I'm going to play for you now our interview with Anita Renfroe. Our special guest is known for her unpretentious Southern charm and laser-sharp wit. She has entertained audiences from coast to coast for more than a decade and is an in-demand stand-up comic and has appeared regularly on Good Morning America. She has turned her gift for storytelling into a multifaceted career and is currently on tour and will be coming to a city near you very soon. We are honored and pleased to welcome Anita Renfroe. Hello.
Thanks, Dawn. I'm exhausted from that intro. I have a question. Did you say laser sharp or razor sharp? Because I probably have a problem with either of those. Which one did you say?
Oh, well, I said laser, L-A-S-E-R.
Laser. Okay. We probably need to dumb that down to maybe halogen. I don't know that laser. I'm over 50 now, so maybe we need to dumb that down to halogen. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. Halogen, well, look, that works. That works for me. Works for me indeed. So
I'm also a little, maybe halogen is too much. Maybe I'm 75 watt. But I think the convenience store with the gas station outside where they have all those halogen bulbs lit up at night.
Yeah.
Have you ever come up on one of those and you're kind of asleep
in
the car? And all
of
a sudden you're blinded by this station that's in the middle of nowhere. I have a conspiracy theory that those are landing strips for the aliens when they take over our planet. So if you've ever wondered why they're so bright.
I know, now we know, and I'm glad you clarified that for us. And just so you know, I think you're hilariously funny, and so you're just off the hip. So that actually was a compliment to your humor and your comedy that you've given us for so long. So it was not a slant by any stretch,
I just wanted to clarify that it may not be laser at all. It may just be down to 75 watts.
Well, now that we all know, that's, you know, we will know exactly where you're coming from, and I just want to start out by asking you now, how in the world did you end up, I mean, what prompted you to want to become, you know, to get into stand-up comedy and to do what you do?
Well, I probably came into comedy through, like, the ultimate back door. I don't know of too many comics that came the same way I did. Most people that decide they want to be in comedy, you know, work their way up through clubs and then try to get a shot on, you know, Leno or Letterman and then try to get an agent and that sort of thing. And I was a stay-at-home mom. My husband was a pastor. I was a church pianist. I was just raising my kids. And I would go and do, like, little women's events where they would have speakers and they would say, you're really funny. Don't do the music next year, because that's what I do. I'd do the music part. They said, come back and do the funny stuff. And I'd be like, I don't know if they're trying to tell me that I'm funny or that I'm a bad musician. I don't know which one is the it's a compliment or a slam. But it was a very, very slow evolution. And after about 5,000 people tell you you're funny, one day you wake up and you go, wait a minute, maybe I'm funny. You know, it was very odd that I didn't think anything about it, but other people kind of called that gift out in me, you know, like, hey, you know, take a look at this. This is unusual. Because I already had this, like, weird party going on in my mind all the time. I just didn't know if it was okay to let it out. So the closer I got to 40 and the less I cared about what people thought of me the more chances I was willing to take, it just seemed that that was a natural part of who I was. And so I started, you know, doing churches. And, you know, like I said, most comics don't start there. They start in the clubs. And so I was on tour with Women of Faith at the time that the Mom song went viral about 7 years ago. And so that's how I got on Good Morning America. So it was really, you know how sometimes you just feel like you just Forrest Gumped your way there when you wake up one morning. One morning you're in your robe, you're watching Good Morning America, and then, like, the next week you're on Good Morning America, and it's, you know, it's just kind of like you don't have a place to put that in your head. So it was a very interesting, different path to notoriety, I guess. But I've always just based my comedy on my own life. I don't write a bunch of stuff that happens. I don't tell stories that happen to other people. It's just my life. So very observational, but very thankful because, man, I love what I get to do. When I hear people laugh, it is one of the happiest sounds ever. And I feel like in our culture right now, you know, we really have to make room and make, like, almost appointments for joy. You know, like, you have to work it into your schedule because we live in such a stress-filled society. So I love what I get to do. I can't believe every day I get to do it. And then, you know, every day I also have this impending fear that they're going to go, wait a minute, you're not funny. We're going to take the mic away. So every day that I get away with it, I'm really excited.
Well, and we're glad that you kind of naturally by accident found your comedic side within you, because you have been making us laugh for a little while now, and it is wonderful. And
thank you.
And I have to ask you, because you, it has been said that you are the person that says what moms think or says what people think. You know, you're the one that's brave enough to say it. We all think it, but you put it out there. And the mom song, wow. I mean, every mom who's ever heard that can say, oh, my gosh, I thought it was just me. Now we know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hitting the nail on the head.
That's kind of the emails we got from women around the world. Really, some of them, that they came in different languages, so we had to get a Google Translator on it to figure it out. But 201, they all said, man, I thought I was the only one. And I think a lot of moms then made their kids sit down and watch it like, hey, look, I'm not the only one. You see that? See, all the other mothers are crazy, too. So I feel like on some level, we might have done a favor for mother and child relationships around the world. But, when I wrote it, I was just trying to express what, you know, my day looked like. And, and, you know, my best friends, I know how their life rolls. And I'm like, well, we can't be the only one. So I just tried to put it all down into something really fast, because that's how moms attack the day. And lo and behold, a billion other moms thought it was exactly how their day went, too. So, it's, you know, when you strike a universal chord, it just, it is what it is. You know, that's how we roll. That's how moms roll on a day.
Well, and the amazing thing about that was that, you know, not only was it fast-paced to kind of mirror the fast-paced day that we live in every day when we're rearing children, you know, but it really, you know, as you heard you express every minute detail that moms in a given day deal with, it's a lot of things that moms don't think about. They're just doing. You know, it's not a thought process.
Right.
They're just doing. So to have it confined to a song per, okay, this is what goes on in my world in a given day. It's exhausting when you listen to it. It's like,
non-moms are like,
oh, my gosh, you know.
Yeah, it helps you recognize why you have that tired feeling between your eyes all the time. I tell everybody that it took me 22 years to live the song and only a couple hours to, you know, make it rhyme. So every mom knows that this, you know, literally that is what all mothers wanted for Mother's Day. I'm sorry, almost nobody got it, but we just really wanted a nap. We just wanted an uninterrupted nap that day. So moms are, you know, we are the tiredest living humans. And we deserve every bit of love and respect that our kids can muster. That's for sure.
Yeah. Now, I have to ask you, you know, you being a stand-up comic and you making people laugh, what do you find funny?
Well, my family almost endlessly provides me, you know, we're kind of a laughing family. When we get around the table, we don't have any of those rules about, you know, no laughing with your mouth full. If we did that, you know, dinner would never get eaten. And I think, you know, I saw something the other day on YouTube, a cat, a little kitten that was scared by a lizard coming up behind it. I mean, who doesn't laugh at that stuff? There's just so much that's funny about real life. I don't really get into a lot of comedy movies or that kind of thing because it doesn't seem real. And I love things that happen in real life that are crazy. Those are the ones that make me laugh the hardest. And of course, you know, there's a lot of comedians whose observational humor I love. I grew up on, you know, Lucille Ball and Carol Burnett and, you know, funny ladies. That's the only ones I saw. I grew up in a really small town in Texas. I didn't even know comedy for a chick was even a career path, to be honest. So it wasn't something I came to early, but, man, I'm glad I finally made it there because, boy, I love what I do. I really do.
Oh, yeah. And the great thing about it is that, you know, as part of what you do, you're able to share your faith, your testimony, and how has, you know, what you've been able to offer to others, how has that been life-changing for folks? What do you think said to people?
Yeah, one of my favorite things when I'm after a show, I stay and talk to people and sign autographs and stuff, which is, I think, you know, it's only fair. They've listened to me for an hour and a half. You know, the least I can do is sit there for a while and listen to them. But one of my favorite things that they say in line, you can, you know, change the circumstances. One of them is, hey, we came with a group of friends, and everything you talked about on the stage is everything we talked about in the car on the way over here. So I feel that everyone kind of feels like I could be their friend, and I love that. Mm-hmm. The other thing is, I'll have people come up and they are kind of shy and they'll say, about 6 months ago, I lost a son to leukemia. He was 16 years old. And I haven't laughed at all since we buried my son. And my friends drugged me to this concert tonight, this comedy concert. And I told them, there's no way I'm going to laugh. It's just not possible. Life's not good yet. And they said, tonight was the first time I laughed, and I thank you for bringing that back into my life. And you can change the circumstances. All the details are different. But I love the fact that when people feel laughter, they feel hope. And just the restoration of hope in people's lives through the gift of laughter. Comedy does so many great things for us. Laughter, not the comedy, but the laughter that results in it. It's great for the endorphins, for the immune system. But I think mainly it's a boost of hope. And the fact that I can bring that, and my comedy comes from a place of happiness and joy because, you know, I feel completely forgiven and free because of my relationship with Jesus Christ. So when I get on stage, I'm not trying to, you know, bash anybody or bring a worldview where there's a lot of hate, you know, involved in it. It really is just out of a place of love. And honestly, people don't care whether you're, you know, a Christian, a Muslim, a Jew, an atheist. They just care if you're funny. And the fact that I know where my funny and my joy comes from makes it purposeful in my life. And I think people intuit that too.
And you are certainly living out God's purpose for you. And thank you so very much. And I wish you the best. You are just phenomenal. I've seen, you know, a lot of your. I would love to get out to see you in North Carolina one of these days where I live.
Oh,
and
that would be great. It would be great
because I've seen all your stuff on YouTube. I mean, it's just amazing what you've done and what you're doing for so many. And so thank you so much for sharing your funny side with us so that we have a reason to laugh.
Oh, I hope so. You know, and I really do believe it's true that whatever you can laugh at, you can survive. So, you know, I really just hope your listeners will take some time out today to remember that and to intentionally find something. You got to reach for it. Like, you know, the world is so stressful, and it's not that it's more stressful than it's ever been before. It's just we have like 24-hour news cycles that remind us of how stressful the world is now. And so, really, if you have a tendency to, you know, obsess about the negative things that are happening, it will just gang up on you. So I really encourage listeners to take some time, seek out something that makes you laugh, spend some time with kids. You know, they laugh about 700 times a day, and the average adult laughs twice. You know, get with some kids, get with something that makes you laugh, and really remember to reach for the element of joy in your life every day.
Well, thank you so very much. That is great advice that it never gets old, and we should always strive to follow daily as part of our walk.
Thank you so much, Dawn. It was great to talk with you.
Oh, same here. It was such a pleasure and an honor, and we wish you much continued success as you continue on your journey.
Thank you.
And we appreciate it. Ah, you've been listening to our interview with Anita Renfroe, and she's just an awesome person. I could have talked to her for hours. She's just that interesting. She's so funny, and I'm sure many of you who follow her and are huge fans of hers, you know exactly what I'm talking about. She currently has a book out. Her latest book is called I'm Not High Maintenance, Just Low Tolerance, and you can actually get that at her website, AnitaRenfroe.com. But you can also follow her on Facebook and on Twitter, and both at Anita Renfroe. And for those of you who are not familiar with Anita, her last name is spelled Renfroe. So check her out and you know, check out what she does. The Mom Song. Just do a search for the Mom Song on YouTube. It is hilarious. And if you're a mom, believe me, you will greatly appreciate it. She says everything that we've ever thought about our kids and about being a mom, and really does. I mean, it's just amazing how she put everything in, you know, a 2 to 3 minute video of what we moms do. So it's hilarious. Check it out today. And we want to thank Anita Renfroe for being our special guest today and for joining us. And we'd love to have her back on at a later date where we could get some calls in from you fans. To chat with her, but so very blessed to have her with us. And that is actually going to wrap our show, and we're going to be off for the next few days, but we'll be back here on Thursday evening at 7 p.m. Eastern, and so we hope that you can join us at that time. And so in honor of our special holiday today, Memorial Day, I want to close our show with a song that I think is iconic and it's timeless. And I don't typically play music by, you know, mainstream artists here on our show, but I felt like today this song was very fitting for the day that we're celebrating. So we're going to close our show today with Elvis Presley and his very famous song, The American Trilogy. Good night, all, or good day, all. God bless, and happy Memorial Day to everyone out there. Take care.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Glory, glory, hallelujah. little baby, don't you cry. You know your daddy's bound to die. But all my trials, Lord, soon.